Hey guys, notice anything different? I'll give you a hint. It's equipment related.
Your girl got a new microphone.
I am so excited, and you guys probably already know this. I asked you if you were okay with me recording some chatty videos for Halloween. So this is what we're doing today. And so much has happened since I sat down to film. First, I was testing out my new microphone. Then I started getting cramps. Then I got invited to the Urban Decay party, which is a Halloween party. And so I was like, oh, that's kind of great because I'm about to do a Halloween makeup. So I have to do this now a little bit faster so that I can get out of here and go to the Urban Decay party. And then I also have to edit this video when I get back from the party. So anyway, I've already gone ahead and covered up my eyebrows, and I've already done some color correcting. That's why my face looks all yellow and splotchy, but oh my god, I'm so excited. The main issue I was having with audio is that I was recording on my iPhone. I was literally using my iPhone as a microphone, and iPhones have amazing microphones, don't get me wrong, but I'd always get this like white noise in the background, and this microphone will hopefully help with that. And if you do hear anything that's kind of like white noise, that's actually my laptop fan in the background because I don't use a monitor to record. I use my actual laptop as a monitor, and so it heats up and the fan starts working. It's working a little bit right now. Hopefully you can't hear it. As I said before, I asked you guys if you wouldn't mind watching some chatty Halloween videos, but there was a percentage of you that wanted the tutorial format, so don't worry. I'm still gonna be teaching everything. My light just moved and creaked. That was weird. Don't worry, I still am going to be teaching everything every step of the way. I'm just not going to be doing it in voiceover format. And that makes life so much easier for me because it makes editing a lot faster. So I'm going to start off with a Mehron Clown White Light for my base. Hold on, I think I actually need to color correct the glue a little bit. So this is just the color corrector I used. It's the yellow corrector by LA Girl. It's weird having a microphone right here. It's literally right in front of my face. You guys just can't see it. But it's really weird having that because I feel like I'm gonna put makeup all over it at any given moment, and that probably will happen. So I'm just taking the Mehron Clown White on a sponge, and this is a dampened sponge, and it kind of sucks that I'm doing this specific makeup right now because I don't have a costume to go with it to the party. So I'm gonna have to improvise something, and I don't know. I don't know what I have that will make this work. And I also, because the microphone is right here, my reflection is also blocked on the mirror. I use a mirror that's right in front and I can't see half my face now. So there's not much to this step. If you want a heavy coverage, you'll probably have to go in with more than one layer, which is what I'm doing. I'm just kind of going over the same area multiple times. Make sure you get all the nooks and crannies. So I like to stretch out my face when I do it. Like that. And I forgot to say, did I even mention what I was doing? So I'm doing Pennywise, but you probably know from the title and the thumbnail. So anyway, I'm doing a cute version of Pennywise because I've been pompifying everything. I've been turning all the monsters into cute versions of themselves. So I thought I'd do the same for Pennywise because he's absolutely terrifying. And I decided to do this look because I didn't jump on the Pennywise bandwagon back when everyone was doing Pennywise makeup, and I thought that, I don't know, maybe I should do it now because I didn't do it before. And this was one of the first looks that I planned out, but it's one of the last ones that I'm filming. But I was actually really inspired to go ahead and do it because recently NYX Professional Makeup took me and other influencers to Warner Brothers Studio for their Halloween event called Horror Made Here. And I got to hang out with Daniel and Christy all night, and they had an It-themed haunted house, and it was terrifying.
Who's gonna kill you?
Christy literally peed her pants. Twice. Twice.
You guys, we went into the It house again, and Christy peed her pants just
again,
a little bit.
Again. Twice today, God.
And Daniel actually fell. Like, something jumped at him and he fell. It was the funniest thing. I was behind the two of them and I was just watching them and laughing my ass off. But I was also terrified. But not gonna lie, it was pretty funny. So I just wanna make sure that my base is really, really even so I can go and set it with powder. And I was supposed to get a package today that I thought was someone sending me a cake because of Adam and I's anniversary. Because when I got like the notification for the delivery, it said cake something, But turns out it's just makeup. I was so excited for cake. I mean, not just makeup. It's obviously I want makeup, but not gonna lie, I was a little bit more excited for cake. So I think I might set everything with the RCMA No Color Powder and then go in with the Sugar Pill Taco to add more color to it. But first I want to set it with this. This is just a translucent powder. And I'm going to use a new brush that Moda sent to me. This is from their Mythical collection. Look at the size of this brush. This is the biggest brush I own and I'm so happy they sent it because this is pretty amazing. And if you guys saw my other Halloween videos, you'll know that I teamed up with Moda this month for a few things. And they gave me a discount code where the discount is bigger this month. So this month it's going to be 20%. Starting next month, it goes down to 10. So if you're thinking of getting anything, I'd say get it while it's still October because then you'll have 20% off instead of 10. And a bigger discount is always nice, obviously. Now I'm going in with Sugar Pills Taco. And it is a matte white eyeshadow that is really, really pigmented, and I am hitting serious pan right now. I need to get a new one. Oh, of course I got powder on my microphone. And I'm just going over everything with Taco because it adds pigmentation. It's a very intense white, so it will help to even out that base. Make sure to really set my eyelids. Okay, since this is going to be a cute Pennywise, I'm going in with the Creepy Cute palette by Strobe Cosmetics. And I'm going to be using the color, strawberry milk. And I'm going to start doing my little rosy nose. Oh my god, I don't know how to work with this microphone right here. So sorry if I'm like in weird angles. Did my light just flicker? Is this thing going to turn off? I swear to god. Or I'm convinced that... Don't you dare. Don't you dare. Just today I was thinking about how I should buy a backup lamp for my light. Hello? Do you need me to open the gate for you? Okay, I'll come down. I have to go answer the door like this. Great. Package received. So I just got this package from Inkovelation. Literally just got it. And I'm really excited about this because I've been seeing these lipsticks everywhere. And I'm super excited for this color. I actually want to swatch it right now because I want to see how it compares to Cider from Black Moon. Because it's like a mustardy color. This one's more, you can already tell the difference. This one's more orangey. But I feel like I'm going to love it. So maybe I won't swatch it. I'll do that another time for you guys. But I might use one of their lipsticks in this look. I might use the red for the lips and the nose. This color Maraschino seems like a really, really good red for our Pennywise. And there's a darker red in here too. So maybe I'll incorporate these. Thanks, Inkovelation. All right, where were we? I was making my nose pink, like I always do. Because it's a cute Pennywise. And no, it's not going to be a pink Pennywise. It's just going to be a cute one. And I want to add pink to the very center of the cheeks. It's kind of like a little circle on my cheeks. This pink might be a little too strong. I wanted it to be very subtle, but I don't think I have any other like pastel matte. Oh, that's not true. So as you can see, there is a very pale pink here, which I'm going to be using to blend this out and like tame it down a little bit. Ooh, it looks darker. But it's not as, like, neon? I don't know how to describe the Creepy Cute palette. It's like, the colors are obviously pastel, but they're so pigmented that it almost makes them look like neon pastels, if that makes any sense. Oh, the microphone is right where I usually have, like, my hand holding the product, so this is, like, really, really weird for me. Back to the whole Warner Brothers studio tour thing. I think this year is their first year doing it, and they only have 5 haunted houses, but they were honestly really, really cool, especially the It one. That was, I think, my favorite. And then they also have a screening of The Exorcist where, like, things happen around you, and that one was really cool, too. But my favorite part of the whole night, and I think it was also Christy's favorite part, I didn't know that the rest of the Warner Brothers studio tour was gonna be open for the public. I thought it was just gonna be the Halloween stuff. So we did the Camp Crystal Lake one, and you have to take like a little golf cart to get there, and you're dropped in the middle of the woods, and then they golf cart you back to civilization. But they drop you off at Central Perk. I don't know if you guys know this about me, but I am a huge, huge Friends fan. I can quote pretty much every single episode. Like, it's practically a lifestyle at this point. If you don't love Friends, you're wrong. So, but anyway, I had always wanted to go to visit the couch because they have the actual Friends couch. All right, it's not a drill. They have the actual couch. And I had always wanted to go, but tickets are like pretty expensive. And I'm like, do I want to spend $100 to sit on a couch? I don't know. So I never went. But then while we were there, we saw that the rest of the Warner Brothers studio tour was open. And that included the couch.
Okay, if you know me at all, you'll know that I'm a huge Friends fan. And, I'm here with Friends, sitting at on the Friends couch.
No one told me life was gonna be this way.
I'm gonna insert the picture right here. And maybe just leave it there for the rest of the tutorial because it's the best picture I've ever taken in my life. Let me start on the next part and then I can continue talking about it. Now I want gray for my eyebrows. I think I'm gonna go in with this gray here because his eyebrows are like carved into his face. They're not really actual eyebrows and I don't want it to be super harsh. So I'm just gonna use a very light gray, but I don't wanna do the same shape as him because his shape is very scary. I might have to concentrate for this. Eyebrows are very serious. I can never talk while I do my eyebrows. I'm doing just like very rounded out brows because I want him to look like a little happy clown, but this is kind of looking a little sad. I don't want to look like a sad clown. I just want to look like happy, bright eyebrows. So we actually took the cutest photo, Christy, Daniel, and I. We were like, oh, let's sit down and do like a fake laughing Friends picture. And so we did. We were like fake smiling and fake laughing until we just like started cracking up and we could not stop real laughing. And look at it. Isn't this the cutest picture you've ever seen in your life? I don't know if I'm crazy, but it looks like this gray has some like pink to it. I can't really see that well out of these contacts, which is weird because they're just regular prescription contacts. I think I have the wrong prescription. I need to go get that checked. And okay, I kind of do like that brow. Okay, it's 6 o'clock. I have 2.5 hours to get ready. That will be hopefully enough time that I can still get some editing in before I have to leave for the party. Because my plan for today was to try to film 2 looks and edit, but I'm gonna end up filming 1 look. And maybe not even have time to edit. Oh boy. Yeah, I did not plan out this 31 days of Halloween thing very well. I have learned a lot from doing it. And I'm not gonna talk about it here in this video. I will be doing a like follow-up to 31 days where I talk about my experience. Okay, this is hard trying to get them to match. It's a lot harder than doing normal brows. With these brows, I feel like Imp Kid right now. If you don't know who Imp Kid is, you should definitely check them out. They are an amazing drag artist and their makeup is always flawless. Okay, they definitely don't match, but you will have to excuse me because I'm used to holding the mirror in a certain position and I can't now because of this microphone. So, okay, I think I'm gonna finish this off camera and then come back. I think this is as even as they're ever gonna get. She says as she still tweaks them a little bit. Right. Okay, I'm just gonna move on. For the eyes, I think I'm gonna use the pink for my transition color. I'm gonna do gray eyes, but I do want everything to be kind of tied in together. His eyes are just plain and gray. They're not very dark, surprisingly. And I gotta say, I did not enjoy looking up reference pictures for his makeup. Because he terrifies me. Oh, and that reminds me what I was gonna say and then somehow got sidetracked when my light started flickering. I was gonna say that I think Pennywise is haunting this video because as soon as I sat down to film, I got cramps and I had been fine all day. And then my light started flickering. It's just, you know, a bunch of little coincidences that makes you go, So I'm just taking this. And I'm applying it above my crease because since I do want this to be my transition color, I want the pink to peek through a little bit once I apply the darker color. I think I'm gonna use that same color that I used for my eyebrows. I'm gonna use that right below the pink. So I'm excited. I've never been to an Urban Decay party before, and I'm not on their PR list. I would love to be, because they are a brand, even though I don't feature them a lot on my channel, they are a staple in my professional makeup kit. I was kind of devastated when they said they were discontinuing the Naked One palette, because that's my, like, go-to palette. Like, if you can only grab one palette, that's the one I grab. I don't know, I just really, really like that palette. It was my first palette, that one with the Sugar Pill Heartbreaker palette. Heartbreaker? Is that the one with the red, the purple? Those were my first two palettes from, like, actual makeup companies, not from, like, I remember my actual first palette was, like, from H&M, but I don't know. I don't think that really counts. Okay, I'm also taking that color under my eyes. I kind of like this combo. So yeah, I do really, really love Urban Decay. So yeah, I'm very, very excited for tonight's party. I'm gonna just go in with Tombstone, but very, very lightly. Ooh, see? Told you this shit was pigmented. Okay, I'm gonna dust off the excess and just use what's there. Also, Chloe, I love you. Thank you for making really pigmented eyeshadows. I don't mean to complain. I literally touched it once in the pan, and yeah, it is quite pigmented. But yeah, the Pennywise at the Warner Brothers tour was absolutely terrifying. He would jump out at you at the end of the maze, the very, very end, when you were like, oh, finally, it's over. We didn't even see Pennywise. He would, like, come out of freaking nowhere. Ooh, I like that. I'm gonna take a little bit more strawberry milk and just blend out the edges. I'm gonna take the gray again and apply it under my bottom lash line this time. And as always, I'm kind of bringing that shadow, making this shape right here. I just kind of automatically do that whenever I do these cutesy looks. Ooh, Adam's home. Hey, yo. You brought me cramp things. You brought me chocolate. Whoa, it's a lot of pads.
Is it supposed to be less?
It's a lot of pads.
Do they usually sell like a 4-pack or something?
No, they sell like half of this as a normal pack.
Not at Rite Aid.
Literally anywhere.
Not at Rite Aid.
Chocolate. Thanks, baby.
You're welcome.
Are you going to a party?
Yes.
Must be nice.
I wish I could bring you, but I'm Daniel's plus one.
Why didn't they invite you?
Because I'm not on their PR list. They don't know who I am.
Well, they're fucking up.
I think I'm going to move on to the nose, and I'm going in with Sugar Pill's Love Plus. Just to do a tiny bit more blending, I am going to apply the same product that I apply on my lips, I'm going to apply to my nose. But I do want to make sure that this is, like, blended out real well. Okay, his nose goes all the way to the nostrils, too. Okay, so there's something in my eye, and I've been putting drops in it, but I swear to God, this look is haunted. Don't know what it is. It's not coming out. So if my eye gets all red, I don't know. All right. I think that's that done. I'm now going to do the lips. I'm going to try the lighter red first and see how I like it. So this is the first time trying these lipsticks. Oh, it's got an interesting smell. Oh, I think this is the perfect red, actually. Oh, that's really freaking pigmented. Okay, so this lipstick feels really intense. And one thing I am going to do is smudge it out while it's still wet. Because I am going to do the signature Pontberry mouth. I look like a little mime or something. Oh, this does smudge out pretty well. Ah, shit my eyes. It's kind of cute. And I'm gonna be a little bit more precise with my application, just so I can get that nice little Cupid's bow that I like to do. I'm doing the little edges like I always do. So what I do is I always extend the edge of my upper lip. So I just draw a bit over it. That's how I get like my cute little lip shape. And then I just overline the Cupid's bow. Also, I really miss doing these chatty videos. And I'm assuming I'm not the only one because you guys voted for me making chatty Halloween videos. I prefer making these a lot more to the voiceover. I honestly hate doing voiceover. I hate recording it. I hate editing it. It just adds so many hours to the video making process. And this way, I'm kind of free to talk about whatever I want. Whereas with a voiceover, I feel like I have to just talk about what I'm doing. And I mean, that can be great, but also I like to talk, if you haven't noticed. I'm also going to apply this color to the tip of my nose because I want both things to match. Really hope this doesn't stain my nose. And if you do get stained by makeup, a great way to remove it is shaving foam. Shaving foam takes off pretty much everything, including special effects makeup. Okay, now I need to, I think, go in with a fluffy brush. Oh my god, I'm not going to be able to smile at this party. See, you guys always comment about how white my teeth are, but if you put on white face paint, your teeth are gonna look super yellow. That's why geisha would always cover up their mouth when they laughed or smiled. And I got lipstick on my teeth. That doesn't help. Fun little tidbit there for you. I'm gonna go in with the red eyeshadow again, just so I can get a smoother blend. I'm just kind of patting that on the edge of the lipstick. Then I'm gonna go back in with a lipstick and kind of do the defined shape, because this is very defined. This is hard trying to hold on to two brushes. I'm always like this. I finish using one brush and then I just hold on to it and then I grab another one and then I'm holding like a million different things. I don't know why I do this. So I think I still want to have that kind of like outline on the nose the way that he has. Like I want to have the sharp edge the way I'm drawing it here, but I want that fade kind of in the background, if that makes sense, just because it makes it look a little cuter. I look so cute. If the lipstick formula was more liquid, I'd be able to use it on a teeny tiny brush like this, but for small detail brushes like this, you want something that's super, super liquid. So I'm gonna go in with the Wolf Red face paint, and oh my god, this is gonna be hard. I'm just kind of doing both sides at once because I feel like I can control that a little bit better. By that I mean I think I can make it look a little bit more even if I do a little bit at a time on each side. I'm just marking where the widest part of that curve is gonna be. Oh my god, these contacts are making it so hard to see, but I feel like these are not even, like at all. But my eyes are freaking out right now and I can't really see that well through these contacts. So I'm going to clean up that line later, but that's more the curvature I was going for. I still think I look like a little mime, and these are completely off. God damn it. See, that's why I'm using a very, very thin brush, so that I have room to kind of still thicken up the lines without it looking crazy. You know when you're trying to correct your winged liner and then you end up making a super thick line? That's what I feel is gonna happen here, but I really hope not. So I'm gonna stop talking so I can concentrate. Okay, well this one's curved more here, this one's curved more here. I'm gonna try to even them out a little bit. Not my best work. But I will say the hardest thing to do is just two symmetrical lines on a stark white background. Oh, it's really hard. And then the lines go over the brows too, so. Ooh, I was gonna try to do that in one sweeping motion, but that did not work. Okay, I'm gonna leave that like that for now because I don't want to risk messing it up. I'm like not breathing right now so that I can steady my hand and my body. This is so hard. I'm gonna go finish this off camera so that this isn't an hour long video, and I'll be right back. Okay, I think this is as even as I'm gonna get it, so I'm going to stop. I'm gonna stop trying to fix it, and I might change the lip shape a tiny, tiny little bit. I just wanna make it a little bit rounder and cuter at the top. It's not cute enough for me. So yes, while this is a pretty simple makeup, do be aware that drawing these lines is very, very hard because one little smudge can just ruin the whole thing. I went a little bit too wide with the mouth here, so I'm gonna go back in with Taco to try to fix that up a little bit. That fixes it right up. Okay, now I think I'm gonna go in with the Strobe Cosmetics Divinity Palette. I'm gonna use the color Bastet just around my eyes. I don't wanna use black in this look. So I'm applying that very close to the lash line, and that just gives a little bit more definition. Apply it to the top lash line too. Me being me, I'm of course going to do, you guessed it, freckles. And for that, I'm gonna be using the Black Moon Cosmetics lipstick in the color Ashes because it is a warm tone gray. I think it's gonna match the eyebrows really well. Just cleaning off my tiny little brush. I need to get more tiny brushes, man. I bought this one for actual painting and then I stole it from my art stuff and put it into my makeup kit. Just taking it on the back of my hand. And the reason I'm using this lipstick on this brush is because it's a very liquid formula. So I'm just gonna take that and I'm gonna do some slightly bigger ones and some smaller ones. Honestly, this lipstick, Ashes, is a lipstick that I probably would have never bought, but it was sent to me and now I am absolutely obsessed with it because it's a warm tone gray and I had never tried a warm tone gray lipstick before, only cool toned. And cool tone gray isn't really flattering. Like, you have to be in a mood, you have to be in a certain mood to wear it, but the warm tone gray is surprisingly flattering. How many freckles are enough freckles? The world may never know. Okay, so I went ahead and popped in my contacts because now I want to finish off the eyes. So I'm going in with the NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk to line my waterline. And I almost ruined my entire makeup when I put in my contacts because a tear came down this side and almost smudged everything, but... So his eyes are lined in black, but I want to make my eyes look really big and cute. So I'm lining them in white. You know what? I'm gonna change things up a bit. I'm not gonna use the Kush mascara today because my eyes are feeling extra sensitive, so I'm gonna use something that's a little bit more water resistant. I'm using the Ico Lash Alert mascara. And this one isn't waterproof, but it may as well be. It stays on like waterproof mascara, and this is one of my all-time favorites as well. It doesn't irritate my eyes. Not that the Kush mascara irritates my eyes, it's just a lot more water sensitive, and since my eyes are kind of like watering and being like crazy, I don't want the mascara to run. So I'm just not gonna risk it. Also, look at how beautiful this mascara is. Like, that result is insane. Before I started using the Kush mascara, this was my go-to, and the only reason I stopped using it is because it's basically a waterproof mascara, so removing it at the end of the day is a nightmare. And the Kush mascara is a lot easier to remove, so that's why it's my go-to for day-to-day. But, ugh, this mascara is gorgeous. Like, look at that. Now, because the look is so simple, I'm gonna go really big on lashes. So for the top, I'm using the Ardell Studio Effects, number 231. This is essentially a demi-wispy and a wispy stacked together. And then for the bottom, I'm using the Ardell 600. And I'm gonna be using the House of Lashes glue. I've used this once before. I'm still kind of trying it out to see how I like it. These look really cool on the bottom lash line. They're really big, but I think it works. And I kind of applied the lashes so that the outer corners meet and it kind of creates just this lash halo effect. It just looks so much like doll eyes. It's just so cute. I can't get over how cute this looks. And here you can probably tell that it's like further down. It's not super close to my lash line, but that's fine. It just opens up the eyes a little bit more. Makes them look more doll-like. It sounds like I'm saying Dalek. Always make sure your corners are stuck down. To hide the glue, I always like to go in with a black liquid liner over the band of the lash. And then I also like to extend this inner corner here, even when I don't do a liner on my eyes. And then if you see any skin peeking through, I like to take the liner and I go through my natural lashes and just draw in between my lashes and the fake lashes if there's any sort of skin peeking through, and then that just hides it. that the lash isn't stuck completely next to your lash line. And that also makes wearing lashes a little bit more comfortable if you don't stick them directly onto your lash line. All right, now I'm gonna do the other eye off camera and I'll be right back. So I kind of can't believe that this is basically the look done. I kind of want to add a little bit more pink around the lips, more specifically right under my bottom lip. Kind of want to bring that onto the chin a little bit. And I also want to intensify that pink around my eyes, because it's looking a little washed out now that everything is said and done. Oh no! That smudged the freckles. Fuck. I thought that was set for sure. Well, now you know, kids. Don't blend over the Black Moon lipstick. Whoopsie daisy. Just gonna pat on a little bit to intensify this side too. That's a shame. Now I'm gonna put on my wig and my outfit and show you the finished look. Ta-da! So this wig is by Arda. It's called the Benny. And it's really, really cute. I know this doesn't look like Pennywise's hair, but I thought it would be really cute. And you can kind of keep it really tame, or you can spike it out like that so that it's more Pennywise-ish. I don't know. This does make me look like I have a really big head. I don't know if it's the way my hair is laying inside the wig cap. I don't know, but it's got these really, really adorable curls that I kind of want to just accentuate. Because look at that. Oh, that's so cute. Oh my god. Oh, I live. I might have to get other colors of this wig. Oh, and I do have a discount code for Arda. It's not an affiliate code. I don't make commission from it, but they did give me a discount code. I'm going to put it up here. It's PomberryArda10, and it's only valid till Halloween. So if you guys are thinking about buying some wigs, I would say use that discount. I really do love Arda. Oh, that's so cute. So I was gonna use this wig for my slappy. I was gonna do the old school slappy, but it didn't arrive on time, and I figured I wanna use it anyway, so that's why I thought about doing the cute Pennywise with it. I think it looks really cute. Oh my god. Oh. Anyway, it is now almost 8 o'clock. I need to take pictures of this look, and I have to put on my outfit, because I'm not gonna wear this. This is like an old school nightgown, but it's like 5 sizes too big on me. It's so long. Like, I can't walk in this. So I am gonna be wearing something else to the party. Still have to decide what I'm gonna put on, because I don't have a clown costume. I don't know what I'm gonna do. But I really hope you guys like this look, even though it's really, really simple. I think it looks so cute. And you don't necessarily have to do Pennywise. If you want to make this look a lot easier, just don't draw these red lines, and you will be the cutest little clown. But yeah. I hope you like this. I hope you don't mind it being a chatty video. There will still be some tutorials that I've pre-filmed and still have to edit further down the line in Pompoween. And I know we're almost coming to an end. I just want to say thank you to everyone who's been watching my Pompoween videos every day. Thank you so, so much for watching. It really makes my day when you guys comment on my videos saying how much you've been enjoying them, because it's been a lot of hard work. So I'm really glad that you guys are appreciating it. And thank you to all my new subscribers for joining in on this Pompoween journey. And if you haven't subscribed already, now's the time to do it. I really hope you liked this video. Enough for you to subscribe anyway. Alright, so I'm gonna go finish getting ready, and I will see you tomorrow for more Pompoween. Thanks so much for watching. Bye!